Hello, welcome back. So let's just craft the bucket of blood. So it's over here. Church workbench. And you have to, well, have a lot of blood on yourself, but that's not a problem. You have, you know, a full dungeon of zombies and other creatures that you can drain the blood of. I'm carrying a lot of stuff with me. I don't think I'll need all of that. By the way, I'm preparing for the research, so that's why I have two random text generators over there working all day on all night. Let's actually put the blood over here, and I also upgraded my morgue. As you can see, it's a lot bigger. I had 14 spaces and now I have 22. So let's just go with the bucket. Actually, maybe we'll need the dropper of blood. I've been working for about 3 or 4 days, so let's see what the refugee camp has for us. But before we do anything else, let's just build the bed. Table, I need a lot of happiness for that, so let's just get another refugee so we can get the happiness faster. Hello, Mr. Vampire, are you still alive? He's still alive. Well, I don't want to see what happens if I give him a droplet of blood, so let's just give him the full bucket, the full treatment of blood. But the taste is amazingly foul. What was that? Horse blood. Well, no one will offer his services, so I guess he still will have his skin burned by the rashes. Sorry, Bob. The squeaky chair. Oh no, not again. Hello, diarrhea, but you're right. Thank you, in spite of all. I bring you some regularly so you can stop bothering the villagers. Yeah, and it's full. I mean, it's morgue blood 100% in a wooden bucket. Vampire sunscreen? Sun cream. I have to spray him with blood. As an evidence of the vampire's demise. Why did you say Theodore would be glad to kill him? Kill you? Oh, it's true. You passed out and never finished your fort. Oh yeah, we have to find a vampire who captured him and tortured him and then made him a vampire. They asked me about the ancient contract and the ancient curse, so they knew. They are somehow connected to the curse and the great blast. Oh, you don't know where they are. That he and the fourth keeper were attacked by vampires. Some strange magic turned their attackers to vampire jaws. Borrow the witch's eye from Theodoro. He's still to act. I mean, he ate a bucket of blood, but I guess it was the wrong blood because he'll get sores and he'll be bad. Yeah, he has to stay over here. Oh man, I have to build one more tent. Oh, I'll forget about the materials that I need. So, I'll just have to bring a lot of flitch, a lot of nails, flitch nails and... sticks. Well, I'll just leave all of this in the camp because I don't want to carry it with me. So, flitch and more peat. Okay, peat is actually the kind of like the fertilizer you get from the crop waste. So let's leave all of these things over here. Sunscreen. Oh man, that's funny. Okay, where is Theodoro during the night time? Well, I guess he's no... By the way, if you look at this, the zombies actually travel near the camp, which is hilarious because they don't even care about the zombies. They are so afraid of the Inquisition, the zombies are just a regular thing. Oh, and you really have to plant the food for them. Well, that's bad and I don't want to do it. But it kind of looks nice. I hope later on we'll be able to, you know, make them use them themselves. Or we could get some zombie in here. Yeah, let's just go to the tavern, because the tavern is always opened. The Dead Horse Tavern, that is. Here it is, the vampire is dead. And that's it, he's convinced. Vampires are over, achievement unlocked. My word. Or economy. Oh, come on, don't talk to me about the economy. We have a huge inn with a lot of patrons, which is exactly number one. The town duties have increased and the harvest hasn't been good to us this past. Okay. 50 silver. Compassion for the common villager. Well, I showed compassion. I helped you kill a vampire. 50 gold pieces, 50 silver pieces is actually a lot of money considering the stage of the game we're in right now. Well, I guess that's the whole quest. Now we have nothing to do but wait. Okay, I guess we can go home and sleep a little bit. Donkey should be back with a few corpses as well, so the DLC has three parts, the refugees, the vampires, and also the donkey with the brotherly revolution, or the comrade revolution. I don't know, this is a weird game. So I should take more peat from what I remember, and I also have, I'm preparing more carrots for the donkey in case he needs supplies or funds. Well, that should be enough for what they have. Okay, hey, I can't move through there. By the way, do you like my garden layout? It was a lot of work to do and I think I could have done a little better and I should change some of these with the zombie gardens. But I think that's just too much work for now, so I'll do it later, because if you just have a lot of zombie gardens, you can just package all the crops you get and then reseed them to make infinite money almost. It's so much easier just by planting the crops and just sending them into boxes into the merchants. Oh, you're still working. Good boy, good zombie. Hey, that's a smart zombie, always working. I actually gave him a lot of stuff to do. Well, I think I said I needed flitch. Must be, yeah, it's good enough like this. And I had nails and I had everything else. Okay, so let's go there, because there's nothing interesting in this day. The only days I want to see are of course the church day and also the merchant day, so yeah. Not much to do over there. Let's also see how my witch burnings are going. By the way, I built this and it's pointless. I actually invested a lot of money into this, but the game says no more witch burning, no, it's useless. And all you can do is leave over there, so yeah. Kind of sad that we couldn't, you know, rescue this house and the field over here. Okay, let's leave the dead body alone. I mean, we have enough corpses to experiment on. Let's go back. Eh, such a funny game. They let you play with the system so much more. Okay. Cooking raton thyroid. Oh man, that sounded terrible. I don't know to think about it. Kitchen? Yeah, let's build her a kitchen. Equal to my luxury kitchen in my former elite restaurant. Well, it will be a kitchen. It will have dishes. You're the one who tried. Okay, this is important. Very, very important. You punch my sales clerk in the nose. A rabid hamster. So, our evil clone is actually in the city wrecking havoc, so this is why I think they'll actually release the DLC for the town. How did they escape from the town prison? I know that silly beard anywhere. Or remember, our character doesn't remember he was stripped of his evil personality by the ancient god. Because that's how he did it, he wanted to make sure we're not going to be evil, so... Yeah, he sent our evil self into the city and he's wreaking havoc there. Well, they have a lot of inventory space. So as you can see, they are a little more happy just because we have more villagers here to be happy. Yeah, there's no point in building the garden beds if you're not going to do anything else. Let's see what he says to me about the Witcher. What? The Witcher's Eye. Let me guess, you want me to bring you something silly? I'll be careful, yeah, give it to me, I'll be real careful. Okay, so this is just waiting. Oh! Happiness just increased enough so I can build a bed, but not the tent. So, I can't have a new refugee because I don't have a tent, so that means I just have to wait. Well, I guess we have time to visit some of the other things. Yeah, I'll do a lot more work off camera because this is a game that requires a lot of work. We could go to our tavern, but first of all I want to check something here. In the church, that is. I think a lot of people are increasing their graveyard standards or their graveyard points, but to be honest, it's so easy to increase your graveyard quality just by building a lot of these statues over here with the marble... what are they? Marble urns. Also a lot of those things over here, so it's kind of silly. I could get an exhum permission to get that dead body out of... I don't want to defile the grave. Defile the graves any longer. So yeah, you just need to have a lot of marble and build the marble flagstones or the... that's kind of expensive, so no. I guess the lawn is the way to go with stone and peat. Imagine that a graveyard filled only with good lawn. These actually look very luxurious. 74. Okay, that's enough. I think I've been playing for a long time, so let's just wait until we skip the time. I'm not sure if there is any way of seeing how much happiness they have in the other place over there. So let's just meditate a little bit until the day passes and we have more time. Now a little recap on the story. I think if you haven't seen the other DLC, what happens is when you get teleported here, the ancient god kind of removes your evil from inside and sends it to the city or the town, and then he puts you over here. So you don't remember anything, but you know from the cutscene. I mean, we know from the cutscene. So I guess we have to kind of rescue ourselves in the process. And maybe then we can go home, because I suspect the ancient god didn't let us go home just because we couldn't go without our evil side, and we couldn't get our evil side until we fix all the problems with the ancient contract. I don't know. So in a way that means we also have to fix... Hello? We also have to fix the problems and find another... successor to our story, so we need to find probably another graveyard keeper. 4 out of 5, we are so close. Then maybe we could go home with our wife. But again, the game just ends, it doesn't really do anything. You want to work here? My servants brought me my collection of toothpicks, nice. What did you get? Well, as long as you are here, you could also work here, you know. I don't mind. Okay, so let's wait a little longer. This is kind of like the bad side of the game, because if you play it right now from the beginning and you have the tavern and you have the refugee camp and you have all of these cool things, though, the game will be so much better. Well, we can go and watch our little improvements in the mining facilities. That's the place we can fish, so yeah. I just like to walk around in the game and see the various things. I think we built that one over there, that lamp. But that's for coal. I don't think we can build a coal mining facility, but as for the others, well, as you can see, the zombies are over here. Good boy, work, work. And I don't know why we have a well here, because it's not that useful. And as you can see, it's a big, big operation. That's the marble, that's the stone. I think this is just an outhouse or whatever it was. And actually removed the furnace from being built here. So as you can see, I have a furnace and also two porter station and also the stone cutter and the little chest over here. Okay, and also a very, very tired zombie. This is also a nice room. I mean, it has some web, some spiders over there, but I guess he could use a little table here and there and it would be perfect. Okay, let's cut down this tree as well. Hey, remove that as well. Ah, this is a nice trip down memory lane. Ah, this looks much better right now. Well, there is still nothing for us to do, so let's go back to our house. And let's pass the time by just using this stone garden or whatever it is, sand garden. Hey, if you remember the beginning of the game, this was added much, much later because people were complaining there is nothing to do while you wait for a certain merchant to come. And I think they should just introduce the option to wake up on Tuesday, wake up on this day, wake up on this day, so you could choose your wake up day. Otherwise, it's just a lot of waiting. Okay, let's go to the refugee camp. So it's kind of hard to predict what will happen next, because if I don't record, I'll lose it. If I record and it's not ready, it will be another problem. Yeah, as far as I know, we can build the tents only over here. So I guess that's the maximum amount of tents we can build. No idea. Anyway, let's just get on with that. What is that scroll for? Or is that kind of like a bed roll? Okay, so now the maximum refugee happiness is 7. And we just need to keep them supplied. As you can see, we can't build any more tents. We can't take the refugee just yet, so it's all about waiting right now. Okay, hope Ney will give me the witch's eye, because that was very hard work. To the 3 of them, okay. Yeah, this camp is much friendlier than a jail cell. It also has a big pot over the fire, which looks lovely. Fresh air and pure well water are in bed. Of course, we want this. All the modern people want this. On automatic well, what do you mean? Okay, so I guess that could be another option, but still. Nothing too crazy. Water well number 2, that also needs 6 happiness. Well, these guys are crazy. I'll need to play a lot more of this. Also, let's put our simple parts in here. And I guess this will be just be a long waiting game. Well, I'll actually be back when I finish building all of this stuff. So the next episode will feature the cooking table, the water well level 2, the beds, and also full refugees. So I guess, by the way, we don't have a way to see how many refugees there are in the camp. No, but probably need one more or two more. By the way, this is a new person that came to live in one of the tents, so I can see 3, 5 people. So I guess we just need to wait for two more people or recruit two more people to have the full camp. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.